Mini chapter 26, Kelly smudges Evelyn. Unknown to Jaymi, Evelyn's freshly minted appearance has been channeled by illicit means to appear not just on his laptop screen, but also on Kelly's in the Sunset Boulevard building. It's a moment when Evelyn happens to be shown peering over her shoulder at her naked self in a mirror, getting to know these much-anticipated new things of hers called visuals. "Oh, look, she's presenting," laughs Kelly to herself, like a panda in a nature film. "Okay, let's fuck her up, shall we?" And she fires up the image editing tools in her software. As soon as he next looks up at Evelyn on his screen, Jaymi receives a clear picture of how an attempt to smudge a beast's visuals is felt by its target, as a visceral distaste, flavoured by the nature of the beast, at what the smudger would presume to impose. Kelly's cheerily destructive attack happens to have landed in one of several scenes throughout The Imagination Thief, where Jaymi has programmed Evelyn to visit a local bar called Downstairs, a place where she is well known, loved, and at ease. Discombobulated and dismayed by Kelly's intrusion into her, however, she can now be seen standing in Downstairs uncharacteristically alone, while all her friends and acquaintances in the bar try to work out what it is about her that's so unsettling, so wrong, all peering at her from alcoves and corners, and failing to be discreet enough for her not to notice they're doing so. Her physical appearance is unchanged from the Evelyn they know, so it must be her bearing that's responsible for the way she now grabs their attention, triggering their shared but unspoken words, "Oh, poor girl, poor creature, but just what is it that's so wrong with her somehow?" There is an unearthly calm, quietness, measure, and control in all her movements, suggesting an unholy kind of self-consciousness, whose presence prompts everyone to try to catch it out by identifying an instant when it's not concealed enough. Never by a flicker does she reveal she knows that everyone is sneaking what glances they can at her. Never does she catch an eye, as a radius of silence extends around her, pushed outward from her on painful struts through the air behind the chatter of the bar. She lights a cigarette, and all her watchers are agog at every stage of this process. Is that a tremble in the end of the cigarette, or is it quite still? Hard to tell. Nobody's cigarette is rock steady, of course, nor is meant to be, but the oddity is that everyone in this bar is doing what they can to catch her out in a single unplanned tremble of the cigarette's tip. And every moment of her life with friends and other people will be like this from now on, it's clear. Every single moment with anybody else for the rest of her days. Her life will be a kind of death. For a moment, Jaymi sits frozen into inaction at the sight of this horror film mutilation of his budding beast, now so perverted from the freedom and ease he imbued her with. Then he snaps out of it and jumps into action. He runs comparisons of successive versions of her code from automated backups to identify everything Kelly inflicted upon it from up in the level of the visual design software, and proceeds to excise or reverse every bit of it, consigning it to the category of alternate life histories that never happened, so that Evelyn will never know what her social interactive fate might have been. Perhaps no one else would quite appreciate why, but Jaymi knows a clear truth. The one who just smudged his beast like this should die.